Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to take a first look at the new Mojo language. So, what is Mojo? It's a new language developed by a company named Modular, and its aim is to have the simplicity of Python syntax with the speed of C and the memory safety of Rust. And that is a tall order to fill. People are rightfully skeptical about these claims, but recently Modular opened the doors to allowing early access to Mojo by way of an online notebook environment. I signed up to join up, and now I have access to the Mojo Playground, which I'm going to be demonstrating. So, given that Mojo is still very much in the early stages, what is it useful for now, and what are its ultimate use cases? Well, the main use case Mojo is being positioned for is the data science and machine learning space that's become a big mainstay for Python, and also for languages like Fortran and R and Julia and MATLAB. Now, it's going to be a while before Mojo is available as a download that we can use on our machines. So right now, this online notebook environment is the only way that we can work with the language outside of the company. But the few things that we're able to see so far are pretty interesting, and I want to walk you through a few of them. Let's start with an example program written in the Mojo language. This is one of a bunch that's included in the online playground as a demo. It's a fairly standard programming demo I've seen in a bunch of different places. It's basically plotting the Mandelbrot set. And it gives us a few convenient ways to look at how Mojo is in action. The syntax, the feature set, and especially the performance, since that's one of the big things that they're claiming for it. So at first glance, Mojo does look a whole lot like Python. It's got the same use of whitespace for syntax, the same general flavor of the syntax. And simple Python programs can run as is, although many elements of the Python language are still very much missing. For instance, there's no support for Python-style lists or dictionaries. There's no comprehension syntax. There are no lambdas. Maybe that's not the worst thing, but you get the idea. The long-term plan seems to be to add support for these things as they go, while still keeping a core of the language that is most crucial for its intended use case. Now, you'll notice as we go through that you'll see that there are some syntax elements that are different from Python. So for one, we have a type definition keyword struct. Now, we can still use class to make new types, as we do in Python, but when we use struct in Mojo, we get something that's more like what the same thing is named in C and C++ and Rust. We get a structure. It doesn't have the dynamism of a Python class, but it's fast and it's efficient. You also notice that we can define Python functions as before using the def keyword, but we have another keyword that we can use for function definitions, fn, and these functions are Mojo specific. They have many more restrictions on them than Python-style def functions. But again, that's because it allows their performance to be considerably improved. Another couple of important keywords in Mojo that are worth pointing out are let and var. And these are probably going to be familiar to people from other languages like Rust or JavaScript. They let you define variables as read-only and as mutable, respectively. So this way, the compiler can make optimization decisions about what to do with those variables ahead of time to speed things up at runtime. And in fn functions, you need to make these kinds of definitions explicitly for the most part. So the idea is that the parts of your program that don't need performance can be written with the easier and more relaxed Python metaphors. And the parts that do need speed, you write them using Mojo's syntax and components. And in some ways, this is similar to the way Python itself works. You can use plain old Python for the day-to-day stuff that doesn't need performance, and then you reach for libraries like Numba and NumPy and Cython when you want speed. And you use those for the portions of the program that absolutely need it, rather than the whole program. Mojo itself can also make use of Python's existing culture of libraries when you need it, by calling into an instance of the Python runtime and importing libraries from there. Now, the downside is that when you do this, you take a performance hit. But as long as you're not calling over and over again into Python libraries in a loop, you're generally okay. In this example, in the Mandelbrot example, we're using the Python library matplotlib to generate this output. And we only need to call it once. We only need to send data over to it once. So our program doesn't spend a whole lot of time going back and forth between Mojo and the Python runtime and the libraries. All the actual heavy lifting is done in Mojo, and then it's just sent to the other side. Another thing worth playing with in the demos, and this is worth trying out on your own if you get access, is how you can use optimizations in Mojo, many of which are not available in Python itself, except maybe by way of whatever's running in a dedicated library. For instance, the Mandelbrot demo, we can run that using parallel processing with only a modest amount of reworking of the code. And just adding that alone yields a 2x speedup. The Mojo Cloud environment is not the best place to test performance. And the makers of Mojo go out of their way to say this themselves. But that said, they also do provide some demonstrations, some examples for how Mojo can be sped up. And some of the best ones are in this other demo, which is an example of how to perform matrix multiplication in Mojo. And they start by doing it first in this very basic, unoptimized way. And then they add various improvements. Just taking the existing Python code and porting it into Mojo, untouched, brings a nearly 20-fold speedup. Now, if we scroll down, we see there's another version of the code where they're adding strong type information, and they're using a matrix struct, which is a Mojo native type. And with that, we get something like a 2,000 times speedup over the original code. And then next, there is a way to add vectorization. This is the use of SIMD instructions. This is something we could only do in Python inside a library. We can't do it in Python code itself. And that raises the performance speed up to over 8,000 times the original. You add parallel processing to that, you're up to nearly 15,000 times. And there's other optimizations that can be done beyond that, like tiling, which helps with cache locality, but those don't have as much of an effect here as they might in other places. Now again, these exact numbers are not as important as the underlying ideas. You can start with slow Python code, you can incrementally transform it into Mojo, and speed things up as you go along. Now to sum up what I've demonstrated here, Mojo is chiefly designed to appeal to the parts of the Python community that use the language for machine learning and number crunching, and also to folks in other languages with the same workloads. It's not yet really being designed as a general replacement for Python in all of its domains, like scripting and web. So it'll be quite a while before Mojo becomes anything like a drop-in replacement for Python, since it's very much under wraps, its feature set is not that large yet. But it's clear the plan is to make Mojo useful in a lot of other ways before it ever gets to that level. And the other thing is that Python has something that is going to make it really tough to displace, which is this huge, vibrant community of users and third-party software. And Mojo can leverage that to a fair degree. But the real measure of Mojo's long-term success, the way I see it, is going to be how much of an audience it can build on its own, hand in hand with the Python system at first, but ultimately standing independently. But for now, these first peaks look really intriguing, and I plan on checking back in over time to let you know how things evolve. So that's it for now for Mojo. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.